Hi everybody, my name is Sonia from Bulawayo, South Africa. Thank you, Roxy. I'd like to talk about Bulawayo Rescue. Bulawayo Rescue was born in 2010 after the closure of Wolf Haven Sanctuary. Wolf Haven Sanctuary rescued, among other breeds, the Bulawayo. Wolf Haven closed down due to financial problems. And being a Bulawayo lover, with some friends, we decided to start a non-profit organization for Bulawayo Rescue South Africa. We rescue, on average, 2 to 3 Bulawayos a month. And some of them come from horrendous backgrounds. I think you all know the story of Gracie and Shinga, Bentley and Sahari. Those are just a few. They're too many to mention. Due to the size of the Bulawayo, and the Bulawayo being a bit intimidating, it can be difficult to rehome them. And people see these fluffy little Bulawayo puppies, and without doing their homework, they don't realize what they're buying. Suddenly, this beautiful puppy grows into a large breed of dog who needs a lot of maintenance, grooming wise. They eat a lot of food, they need training, they need socialization, and sadly, the people found themselves outmanned and the expenses too high, and so the Bulawayo ends up in the backyard, neglected, abandoned, or comes up for rescue. Another reason why we get so many Bulawayos in for rescue, and I'm not going to go into detail about that, but many people are immigrating from South Africa, and the expense of taking a Bulawayo with is huge. And so we are called to help rehome these dogs. I'd like to talk a little bit about foster homes. We have only 3 foster homes in the whole of South Africa. Fostering is not an easy job. Many of the Bulawayos that come in have never been in a home before. They're not potty trained. They haven't been socialized. So it's very difficult to find a foster family that has an existing family of dogs where this Bulawayo will fit in. When a Bulawayo comes in, the first thing that happens is they are spayed and neutered. They are fully vet checked. They are microchipped. And then only can we start looking for a home. Before the homing procedure can take place, the Bulawayo has to recover from the surgery. And with the amount of foster homes we have, it's very, very difficult. Kenneling is expensive. Nobody's going to give us a kennel for nothing. And the other problem with kenneling is that there's no one on site that knows the Bulawayo. And Bulawayos need to be with people. They need attention. And for this reason, kenneling is just not an option for Bulawayos. I know there are people that are unhappy because we rehome Bulawayo cross dogs, but we feel it's not their fault. And so we would like to help those dogs as well. One of our biggest challenges are vet bills. Vets are not cheap. and our fundraising efforts bring in money. We have a Christmas in July auction every year. We have ladies that knit and paint for us. We have smaller auctions. We try as hard as we can to raise funds. Being a breed-specific organization, we don't get donations, donations like other organizations that rescue all breeds. Most of our donations come from you, the Bouvier lover. You know the breed. You love them. So we are totally dependent on our Bouvier lovers. This year, for the first time, we are attending the biggest expo in South Africa, in Gauteng, Wodak. It was a very difficult decision, but we felt that this would put Bouvier Rescue in the public eye and make people aware that we exist, with the hope that we will be able to eventually acquire more funding, a sponsorship, a Bouvier lover that might be able to help us with our dream. And our dream is a sanctuary. We have a wonderful Bouvier Rescue team of five. I will name them: Julia Keddy, Audrey Soul, George Soul, and my husband Bertie. We are asking for people to please, if possible, donate monthly if you can. As you can see, we live on a conservation farm. It's not ideal for the Bouvier. We have wildlife. It's beautiful. It's absolutely beautiful. But with the wildlife, it can be dangerous as well. And not ideal for Bouvier Rescue. So our next project is to find a sanctuary. A sanctuary where we can keep the dogs that need rehabilitation, training, attention, where we can help them before we rehome them. And there are a lot of them that come in that need this. Thank you, Rommel. I don't want to get emotional. I don't want to make this a long video. But I'm pleading to every Bouvier lover out there, every Bouvier lover on our Facebook page, every dog lover, please help Bouvier Rescue achieve our dream, the Bouvier Sanctuary. Please visit our website, Bouvier des Flandres Rescue, South Africa, .weebly.com. Go to our Facebook page, Bouvier Rescue SA. See the work we do. And I'd just like to thank you for watching this video. And I believe that someone somewhere, Bouvier lovers with big hearts, will help Bouvier Rescue in South Africa. Thank you.